Honorable Vice Chancellor Jamia Millia Islamia Professor Talat Ahmed, our international faculty from University of Pennsylvania, Professor Ravi Sheth, our GIAN coordinator in Jamia Millia Islamia Professor Aman Jairajpuri, Center for Theoretical Physics Director Professor Sami, the Director of Research Jamia Millia Islamia Professor Ghosh, my senior faculties, participants, students, colleagues. On behalf of Center for Theoretical Physics, I welcome you all for this GIAN course on cosmological structure formation, which will take place in Center for next five days. So this GIAN, which is a global initiative for academic networks, it was a venture by MHRD, Government of India, to garner the best international experience into a system of education, enable interaction of students and faculty with the best academic and industry experts from all over the world, and also share the experiences and expertise to motivate people to work on Indian problem. And there is a need for this kind of school. And with this GIAN program, it's extremely good that in Jamia, already we have 28 GIAN program, which is one of the highest, I think, in India. JNU has around 21 or something. Another couple or four or five are in pipeline. And it's really great. In Center for Theoretical Physics, we already have four programs already. And this is our fifth program in Center for Theoretical Physics. And we are also, other proposals are in pipeline. Once the GIAN will be again open, we'll put those proposals. Our faculty, Professor Ravi Sheth, just a few lines for him. Professor Ravi Sheth had been educated from Haverford College, Pennsylvania, as a Dana S. McGill scholar. He obtained his PhD from Institute of Astronomy, University of Cambridge, where he had been a Marshall scholar. And he has worked as a researcher in Fermilab of USA, the Max Planck Institute, Garching, and University of California, Berkeley. And currently, he's a professor at the Department of Physics and Astronomy at the University of Pennsylvania, United States. And he had been also a senior research scientist at the Abdus Salam International Center for Theoretical Physics, or ICTP, Trieste, Italy. And he is holding many numerous visitor positions in Ames, Cape Town, South Africa, Muda Observatory, France, Faclay Institute, and many more. Professor Sheth's research interest involved developing physical models and statistical methods which allow the data from large-scale galaxy and cluster surveys to construct models for galaxy formation. He had played a major role in the development of the HALO model, and which is the standard model for nonlinear clustering. And he developed the first realistic, fully analytic model for non-local bias using the excursion set approach and peak theory description of the cosmic wave. He has published more than 150 research in this field. And he's principal investigator of many NASA projects, also part of the Hubble Space Telescope project. So it's really a pleasure and it's a proud moment for us that Professor Ravi Sheth kindly agreed to be the faculty for this course. And overall, he's an excellent teacher. And so I believe the students will be benefited a lot. He'll be here for next five, six days. There are many discussion and tutorial sessions apart from the lectures. So the students should take the fullest opportunity to learn from him. I now just request some of our students to just say give some memento or souvenir from on behalf of Center for Theoretical Physics to our guest. So, So now I request our director, Professor Mohammad Sami, to say a few words about the center.
Colleagues, dear students, actually it is a great pleasure to witness the commencement of fifth GIAN program in the center. And this GIAN program has added to the visitors program of the center, which is the backbone for the center. And if this center had some limited, you know, progress and success, is due to our visitor program. The GIAN has provided us a platform to invite eminent experts in the center. So center, if I said, had some limited success, as Narligar said, that this is the unique center in the university sector which has succeeded. This is due to our visitors program. And see, in Indian in India, the structure of education or research in university and center research centers is very, very different. It's a very poor funding in the university sector, unlike the research institutes. And in university sector, nothing can succeed if you do not enjoy the support of the vice chancellor and the administration. Really, we have been lucky that we have had eminent vice chancellors who came to us in sequence one after the other. And that helped us a lot. So this is one of the key reasons. The other key reason is that our colleagues working in research institutes in India and abroad have overwhelmingly supported us through their visits, through their sponsorships for our programs, through their collaborations with our faculty, the students. Center is small. It has six faculty. It was established in 2006, not very old. And one of the focus or the thrust area is cosmology. Cosmology today is the hotmost subject in physics. The reason being that it's related to large observational missions in cosmology, related to testing the early universe physics, related to structure formation, which Ravi Sheth is associated with, related to gravity waves, finally. And the recent discovery of gravity waves has added lot of support, lended lot of support to cosmology. So, well, this wasn't the situation in past. It brings me to my old days in Moscow State University. I joined PhD in high energy physics department in 78. And next to our department, the father of modern cosmology, Zildovich, used to teach 1 year course on structure and evolution of universe. Irony that none of us went to attend that course because at that time cosmology was not supposed to be the part of physics. It was supposed to be the part of philosophy. Even after 1965 discovery of microwave background, which added respect to cosmology, but it didn't make the part of physics. It was only after 1980, after cosmological inflation was invented, it became the part, integral part of high energy physics. See, then it is going hand in hand. Not all hand in hand. Now cosmology has gone further. Particle physics is following it. They have to test their models, many of them, in the early universe. So this is a good time, really, for cosmology. And cosmology answers many profound questions. After inflation, it can address a very, very important question which mankind from early days has always asked. What is our origin? From where we have come? Well, religions, all doctrines related to nature address this question. Cosmology has a precise answer to this question. Religious people like it, don't like it. So the answer is, from where we came, we originated from quantum fluctuations. So we came from quantum fluctuations. This is the answer of cosmology. And these tiny perturbations generated quantum mechanically during inflation via gravitational instability have grown into the beautiful structure that we see in the universe. So how that happened is the part of structure formation as a very important part of cosmology. And really it's a great honor and for us that one of the eminent cosmologists is here to teach you the basics of structure formation. I am sure a very hectic, interesting week ahead. I am sure you would enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Sami. I now request Professor Aman Jairajpuri, the GIAN coordinator at Jamia Millia Islamia, to say a few things, few words about GIAN program in Jamia.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Ravi Sheth, Professor Sami, Professor Anjan, and other dignitaries of the dais, and dear students and faculties, young faculties who have arrived. so First up, you know, as Professor Anjan said, that this is the fifth course, you know, which is being held in this center. More important was that the center took lead initially when the GIAN, program was announced. And Professor Anjan, Professor Sami, and Professor Sushant Ghosh, these three were, I think, the initial, most initial GIAN programs which we had. And that's sort of sets the tone and as he told that we are now having, this is the 28th program which we are having, and we have more in the pipeline. And this is the among the programs held in the universities, this is the highest number of program. It is very important to know that you have arrived here and you have taken that effort. There is a lot of background work which goes into right from the conceptualization and conceiving of a topic and identifying an expert who comes, and then both the local expert and the foreign expert, then they go through. So it goes through a stepwise and a lot of maneuvering behind the back, and finally you come to a point where you are sitting in front of a faculty who is an expert in a specific niche, especially cosmological sciences. Even for, I am a biological sciences professor, so for me there is the interesting aspect is a lot of lot of parallels between the at the molecular aspects of organization which is there, and I'm a cell biology teacher, and how the spirals spiraling galaxies and they are set. And now what has happened in last I think 3-4 years is that continuously there is the generalization of of the area of the concept of cosmology has happened through lot of newspapers. For example, I know that X-ray binaries and the now in the Milky Way, this is just 2 days back in the newspaper that there may be thousands of black holes, which are there. And so it has become a very important area where, and it is also one of the leading areas in terms of, you have, for example, nanotechnology. And so, and this advent is actually seen in the, with daily, almost every week you get an article, if you are interested and a layman like me. So, and obviously it is definitely linked to our origin, as Professor Sami pointed out. So you are, the point is that when you come here, there are a few things, and that is that once the expert is taking a lecture, obviously, the point is that there are gray areas, areas where you can he will identify gaps for you. And during the course, it is important, if you are attentive to, pick those gaps, because for young researcher or young fellows, I think it's very important that we have, we know the areas where we can push ourselves, So that is, and in this interactive setting, I think this is the best, and that's why these programs have been, actually, believe me, there are these, out of these 28 programs, what is so, so overwhelming is the amount of things which, a foreign faculty is inculcate in you. So if you are serious and you have arrived, with intention, and then in this interactive mode, obviously you will gain a lot, and this is very minor thing to say. So being the local coordinator, definitely I put my whole support in, and if there are any problems, issues, and you can always contact me. And especially for the people who are visiting Jamia, for the first time, I will ask you to just visit the campus. This is just a recent survey. This is the last point. Our university is 12th among all the universities in India. It is 19th among all the institutes, and it is, I think, 6th or 7th among all the central universities. And this program, I think 2 years back was got a president award, in the Central of Theoretical Physics, and so this is an important one, point that obviously you also see, and this is also one of the mandate that you see that if there are researchers who are close to your area, you go and meet them. And also for young faculties who have come here to seek some sort of collaborations, you know, among yourself and also some sort of mentorship also from the foreign faculty, which can be long term. So thank you so much and, you know, and welcome to this course. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Joy Rajpuri. I now request Professor Ravi Sheth to share a few words about the course that he is going to.
So first, thank you for the honor. It's a real pleasure to be here. I must say I'm not surprised that that there have been so many GIANs here because, you know, the faculty here are great. And so it's wonderful to come and join them and participate with them in the learning process. I second everything that was said earlier about visitor programs. I wish we at Penn had a visitor program like this. It's an enlightened thing to have long-term visitors who can come and spend plenty of time with students, with postdocs, with other faculty. Cosmology. So I'll be talking about structure formation. And you know, usually when we teach physics, when we talk physics, we say the important thing is the laws of physics are the same everywhere. They're the same all the time. So now is no time special. Here is nowhere special. But for these courses, that is not true, okay? This week is a special week in a special place, and certainly I feel it, and I hope that you come away feeling the same. Yeah? I will be talking the first day or so will be just setting the stage. It will be pretty light for some of you, just to make sure that that we know where the field stands currently, okay? So it will be a lot about observational cosmology before we start making more theoretical models, looking for understanding of the basic observational facts. We will start out in the coming days just doing simple equations of motion, the consequences of equations of motion, until finally we come to trying to describe the difference between dark matter, which we think is what most of the universe is clustered with, and the light, which is what we can observe. And so we will be sort of building the framework for making a description, what I like to call an unbiased description of the universe from biased tracers of the universe. Yeah? And so what you see is not what you get. And so we'll be trying to figure out what is underneath the light that we're fortunate enough to see. Okay. I hope by the end of the week, you will have the language for doing this. I'm here all week. I have no other commitments. So please use the lecture time, use the tutorial time, use all the extra time to ask me questions and to ask the other professors here. Because that's why I'm here, yeah? Good, so I stop there, and thank you again for the invitation, and looking forward to the course.
Thanks, Ravi. So now I request our Honorable Vice-Chancellor, Professor Talat Ahmed, to formally inaugurate the program and address the participants.
Good morning and assalamu alaikum. Professor Ravi Sheth, Professor Sami, who is now going to be the, from today or tomorrow, the Dean of the Science Faculty. So, and he's from your center, so your center becomes even more important now. Professor Aman Jayarajpuri, Professor Sen, Professor Ghosh, my other colleagues, and my dear students from this university and other universities, and some of the faculty members who are attending this. It is good to see people like Professor Seth coming to this center and to this university and lecturing. Particularly, this is because of the help of the Government of India to support this GIAN program, where we can get experts from all over the world to come and stay with us, and students and teachers, they get chance to interact and also work short-term and long-term collaborations. That is very important. So I am very sure, and the way Professor Seth's body language says, you should try to explore as much as possible to learn, and also the bright children should try to look for better careers. How to do that, and what are the areas where you should do research, and what are the leading areas? Because as I understand that cosmology and geophysics, cosmophysics, I am a geologist, so I keep telling geophysics. So we actually know very little about this very complicated and big universe. How much we think we know is very, very little to what the big story is. So I am very sure that Professor Seth will highlight these and make you aware of it. And then at the end of this week, at least, some of you will get some new ideas and thoughts to do research and then contribute to the understanding of cosmology and earth physics and the cosmophysics, cosmochemistry. And obviously, questions like from where we have come, as Sami Sahab has said, okay, there are lots of questions, lots of controversies, so we should try to get the right answer, which may not be so easy to answer, but at least there are ways to approach. In science, we have to do things logically and put your thoughts in the logical fashion and come out with a model. So I hope that this 1 week course will be very useful, and Professor Seth, I hope that you will have a good stay here, and you will have good interaction with the participants of this course. So I officially inaugurate this course. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. So now I invite all of you to join us for a tea outside, and then we'll start our formal program around 11:45, and in between I'll tell you where to register. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you.